Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. It's been a while since the brand new MacBook Air with M2 chip was released, and we finally finished the charging test of this laptop. What we got is the 512GB model, so there is a 35W compact charger inside. We've made multiple videos to test and take apart this charger. You can click the upright corner to check that. Just like the MacBook Pro, it comes with a MagSafe 3 to USB-C cable. We also took it apart last year. The best color in my opinion must be salt light. The thickest part is even thinner than the previous model. This time you can charge it through two USB-C ports and the MagSafe 3 port, and only the headphone jack is on the other side. We'll test the charging compatibility of USB-C and MagSafe 3 respectively. And also, we'll pick up Apple original chargers and some third-party chargers from 20 to 100 watts. Let's start from MagSafe 3. The peak power can reach almost 68 watts, slightly surpassing the M2 MacBook Pro 13 inches. And any PD charger can be compatible with this laptop. You can even use a 20 watts charger to charge it. And then let's switch to the USB-C port. We can easily find from the result that the USB-C and MagSafe port differs by about 1 watt or 2 watts, and both can reach almost 68 watts. The MagSafe 3 is pretty convenient, but is essentially the USB-C. So if you want to choose a third-party chargers for your MacBook Air, make sure you have a 65W charger or above for the fastest speed. Next, we'll use the Apple 35W traditional charger, the upgraded Apple 67W and Apple 140W to charge this laptop fully. Here is the fully charging test of 35W traditional charger. The voltage is about 20 volts throughout the test, and the peak power is about 32 watts. Then it'll drop to 25 watts, and finally, it takes about 2 hours and 32 minutes to be fully charged. And the charging curve of Apple 67W charger can be divided into 5 parts. The voltage keeps at 20 volts, and the power curve varies with the current curve. Its peak power is about 63 watts, which is double the 35 watts. The total charging time is 1 hour and 57 minutes. The charging curve of Apple 140W is almost the same as Apple 67W, but the 67W is much more stable. The 140W only reaches 67 watts, which should be the charging limit of the new MacBook Air. The power curve also varies with the current curve, and is only 4 minutes faster than the 67W charger. We put all three curves into the same chart and can more intuitively see the difference between them. The 35W charger can charge 27% in half an hour and 55% in an hour, and it takes 2 hours and 32 minutes to fully charge. The curves of 67W and 140W are almost overlapped. Both can reach more than 50% in half an hour, same as what Apple claims. And the 67W charger is even faster than 140W in the first hour. But 140W finally wins the championship. Well, that's the charging review of the MacBook Air 2022 with an M2 chip. After the fast charging is added to MacBook Pro, it finally comes to the MacBook Air. Compared with the previous generation, it can reach almost 68 watts. It's also the reason why Apple offers the most charger options ever. So if you want to opt for smaller third-party chargers, 67 watts is pretty enough for this laptop. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.